Very good morning to one and all. I am Srishti from Vaimana Institute of Technology, and today I am presenting my report on interior design. I would like to thank CMTI for providing this opportunity, and I'll start my presentation. Today I'll be presenting about the different types of units available in the residential, and about the modular kitchen and some of the softwares for interior designing, a small introduction on SketchUp, and also a small introduction to Vastu Shastra. So firstly, what is interior design? It is the art of enhancing the interior of a building to achieve a healthier and more aesthetical pleasing environment. Interior designing is categorized into main types. Firstly, the residential and the commercial. It takes about 45 days to design a residential building and about 6 months to 1 year to design a commercial building. These are the different units available in residential: wardrobe, living units, puja unit, crockery unit, shoe rack and foyer unit, and lastly the modular kitchen. Next, we'll learn about the construction of a wardrobe following few of the steps. The step one consists of the design of wardrobe components. These are different wardrobe components which are used in the construction of a wardrobe. Firstly, gable. Gable is the part which forms the basic structure of the wardrobe. It is formed by the intersection of the material which the wardrobe is made of. Next comes the hanging rod. These are basically used for hanging clothes, and they can be kept according to the requirements. Next comes the fixed shelves. These are used for keeping stuff. The headroom for these spaces can be as per the requirements, and the adjustable shelves are for the smaller stuff and can be adjusted whenever required. Next comes the drawers. These are one of the important part of the closet, which is used to keep the stuff that we do not want to display. And the second step is deciding the type of wardrobe we want. These are the different types of wardrobes. First one is the sliding wardrobe. These are the modern take on traditional hinge door wardrobes. According to the available space and width, a sliding door wardrobe can be designed with two or four doors. It occupies less space, allowing for more free space in the room. Next one is the hinge door. These are the most popular wardrobe style, and it is recommended only if we have enough space in the bedroom. These are also known as closed wardrobe. Next is the walk-in wardrobes. These wardrobes are the epitome of luxury with massive storage space for the clothes and other accessories. The standard walk-in door will have hanging and storage space on all the three sides. It is ideal for rooms with enough space and separated with a pair of doors, making it an ideal walk-in closet. Next is the mirrored wardrobe. These are the great consideration that improves the visual appeal and can elevate an ordinary room into a dream bedroom. This was about the type of deciding the type of wardrobe. Next is the positioning of the wardrobe. Before positioning the of wardrobe, we should make a floor plan, and we should mark the area where the wardrobe is to be placed. Following are few of the guidelines to be followed while positioning of the wardrobe. The wardrobe length should meet our requirements, and there should be enough walking space which should be provided in front of the wardrobe. And if the wardrobe is placed next to the door, at least 500 mm of gap should be provided between the wardrobe and the entrance. These are a few of the important points while followed during the placement of the wardrobe. Firstly, the standard specified area. It should be placed on the standard specified area. It can either be placed on the straight wall or to the left corner opening of the room or to the right corner opening of the room. After deciding the placement, we can create as many designs as possible, keeping our basic requirements in the mind. And fourth step is the selection of materials for the wardrobe. These are few of the basic materials: MR or BWR plywood, particle board, and medium or high density fiber board. MR or BWR, also known as moisture resistant or boiling water resistant plywood. These plywoods are most preferred. These are most preferred, and these are prepared by combining layers of wood cutting sheets together, and they are bind together using the binder, which is urea formaldehyde resin. There are three types of available three types of plywoods available in this. First one is the moisture resistant, which is commonly used. BWP or BWR, which is boiling water resistant. This is used in areas which is prone directly to water, like in the bathroom and kitchen, etc. These are not economic for the construction of wardrobe. Next one is the marine plywood, and these are frequently used in the construction of docks and boats. Next one is the particle board. These are made by joining the chip wood and wood shavings and sawdust together. One type of particle board is pre-laminate particle board, and the pre-laminate particle board lasts longer than a non-laminated ones. These are available in different densities, colors, and viscosities. Next one is the medium or high density board. These plywoods are made by sticking fiber particles together with the help of the resin, and it has more strength than the particle board and is cheaper. Next is the selection of finish material.
One second. See, the finishes, about the finishes and the interiors, if you take a small 3 BHK house, a 3-bedroom house, you can do the interior finishes for a budget of 5 lakhs also, and for the 50 lakhs also. It depends upon the materials, what you select, how much you have the budget. This one, an interior designer has to understand the things, how, what is the cost, what is the pricing, what are the various materials available. You can show, because based on the customer's budget, you can plan the things. Whether you need a material with a lower quality, or whether he needs a higher finish or thickness, because a lot of maintenance and other issues also comes into place. So one should understand about the customer's budget requirements, whether they need maybe if your house is going to be rented, will you give a finish or normal finish? If you are going to give your house for rental purpose, which one you will do? Rich finish you will do, or a normal finish?
Normal, sir.
Normal. And if you are going to do the interiors for a jewelry shop, and you will do the interiors for the hardware shop, which one you will prefer? Where the richness you have to show?
In the jewelry shop and the hardware shop.
Yeah. See, in the hardware shop, what happens? The people will be coming for the purchase of material. For jewelry shop, high-end people will be coming. You need a very high richness, the lighting and everything. All these things comes into the picture. So you have to understand the customer's requirement. What is my customer's requirement? Where, which kind of people will be coming? What are the materials I can give to them? Even the flooring. Whether I need a vitrified flooring or a marble flooring or a granite flooring depends upon your customer profile and end user profile. You will be selecting the materials. On that time, the selection of materials, a lot of people think, oh, boss, the interiors is not my domain, like they will think. That's not true. That is your domain only, where you will read the drawings, you select the materials, you are involved in the costing, you are involved in the execution also. But a lot of architects are there in the design, but a lot of civil engineers are not coming forward to take this as a career. But in CMTA, this is one of the options we are giving. Who are the people interested on this? They can take the interior design also, interior design and site management, this thing. depends upon the liking, which, you know, for a budding level engineer, we are giving various options. After one internship, they found out which one is suitable for them, then they will take the various exposure. This presentation and all, what you are doing, there's also learning from your presentation. That's called peer learning, we say. Because based on your presentation, they are also learning. From their presentation, you are learning. That's a peer learning platform. And by doing the presentation only, you are gaining much knowledge about on the subject. The confidence level grows up. Okay, you proceed further.
Yes, sir. Next is the selection of finish material. Firstly, the laminates. Laminates are most frequently used finishing material for plywood, MDF and particle board wardrobes. They are made by compressing layer of plastic resins and paper. A colored layer or textures are then added on the surface. There are various kinds of laminates available in the market, such as matte finished laminates, glossy finished laminates and digital finished laminates. And next one is the colored glass or mirrored glass. Wardrobes fitted with glass gives an elegant and contemporary look to the wardrobe. One advantage that the wardrobe with glass has in that it can get along with any sort of decor, irrespective of the type of glass we use. Next type of the finished material is veneer. Veneer is another finishing material that can be used, and they are made by slicing and peeling of the tree trunk. There are various kinds of veneers available in the market and can be chosen based on our choice. Next one is the acrylic finish. This is another material which is frequently used these days. They are non-toxic and similar to lacquer. These finishes are available in wide range of colors with reflective high gloss finish. Matte finish, ultra gloss finish, and wood grain finish. These were about the construction of wardrobe. And next we'll come to the living room units. Living room consists of many other aspects, but sofa set and TV panel are the two main important things. And selection of sofa set gives an elegant and glossy look to the living room. And the most durable fabric options for the sofa set include the cotton, linen, and synthetic microfibers. Next is the TV panel. Getting the perfect TV panel is more complex than we think, and we should consider depending on the size, design, material, and the quality. Keeping these two things in mind, a living room can be designed. Next one is the puja unit. These are some of the types of the puja unit. Puja unit can be designed based on the availability of the area. First one is the doored puja unit, and second one is the partition at the side of the wall, and next one is the separate room for the puja unit. These can be designed based on the availability of the area. Next one is the crockery unit. Crockery unit is also one of the important part of which elevates the interior of your home. These are the two types of crockery units, one with the cupboard and one with the cabinet. And next one is the shoe rack and foyer unit. This is one of the shoe rack which can store more number of
crockery unit and the kitchens. You have to discuss with the end user requirement. Maybe all the people may not be comfortable with the same standard units. So who are working on the kitchen, you have to discuss with them what is their requirement. You have to understand, and accordingly you have to decide the units over there, design the units over there. That generally takes place because the end user, they should feel the comfortable. They spend much time on the kitchen. So you have to check the end user requirement also.
Yes, sir. The next one is the shoe rack and foyer unit. This is one of the shoe rack which stores more number of sleepwears, and it gives an elegant look. Next one is the foyer unit. The term foyer describes the space that usually connects the entrance to the various other rooms. In other words, we can also say it is a place where we welcome our guests. And these are usually spacious, and there's a plenty of room here for the furniture. Next one is next important factor unit is the modular kitchen. These modular kitchens not only look trendy but also very convenient to work. These are the four steps to plan our modular kitchen. First one is the defining the layout or shape of the kitchen. These are the type of the kitchen layouts. First one is the one wall kitchen. These are usually found in small smaller kitchens, and these are usually found in the these are usually for the smaller areas. It works very well for the large open area homes as well. These have a single wall design for keeping all utensils, appliances, and ingredients with the easy reach. Sliding door can be provided if the space is constrained. Next one is the galley kitchen. Galley kitchen is also known as a parallel kitchen. These kitchens are basically two parallel workspaces with movement area in the middle. And next one is the L-shaped kitchen. L-shaped kitchen, L-shaped modular kitchens have been popular for decades because of the versatility it offers. And it consists of two adjoining walls perpendicular to each other, which make up the workspace. Next one is the U-shaped or C-shaped kitchen. These are the best for small spaces. It features a horseshoe-shaped work area with counters, cabinets running around the sides. Such kitchen can accommodate one or two cooks. Next one is the island kitchen. It is a good idea if we want the store to be accessible from all the sides. These layout design allows two or more people to cook together, and it functions as an extra workspace and a place for the family meals. Next is the peninsula kitchen. It is also a type of it is related to the island kitchen. It incorporates a kitchen counter that just comes out from a wall or cabinetry. This peninsula can be used for food preparation, eating, or other tasks while the cook is busy with the meal preparation. Next one is the kitchen cabinets. These are some of the kitchen cabinets. The main focus while designing a kitchen goes to the kitchen cabinets and modules. Each module will have a shelf, drawers, pullouts, etc. All of these have their own unique advantages and usages. Shelf modules are the cheapest modules. Corner modules offer various options for the accessories. And wall modules can be hinged or lifted up. If there is a budget constraint, then we can go for hinges. But with the modern budget, one can opt for the lift-up cabinet, which gives easy access to the storage. Next one is the materials used in modular kitchen. These are the two main important things while selecting the material.
People to visit the experience centers. Each and every company is having their own experience center. If you take Live Space, Design Cafe, Home Lane, Bonito, everyone is having their experience center. If you go there, if you see the things, then you will understand well. When the time permits, you can ask our office to get a permission. You can go and visit there, so that you can understand more about the things in the life. By seeing, you can understand more. Okay, by touching and feeling, then you will understand the four things. And in turn, we arranged so many factory visits also. How exactly it happens in the factory, lot of people go to factories and they see what are the materials, how it is being processed, step by step procedure also. They will, in our detailed programs, they will go through this training on the factories, training on the experience centers and other things. Then you will be confident enough to make the designs.
Yes, sir. So these are two important thing while selecting the material quality and looks. The cabinet material for kitchen is made to last for 15 years. So it is necessary to ensure that the material used is tested against the water, termites, etc. Here are some of the variety of finishes such as veneer, foil, acrylic, polymers, laminates, PU paint, glass, etc. The base material can be super tough HDF plywood, aluminium frames, etc. Depending on the budget, one can choose the base finishes and base material. Super tough HDF with foil gives the best combination of price along with a 10 years warranty. Next is the kitchen countertop. A well-chosen kitchen countertop makes your kitchen more useful and easier to maintain, and it can also serve as an important design element of your kitchen. Here are some of the kitchen countertops. The most commonly used kitchen countertop is granite slab and quartz slab. And next important factor is the kitchen work triangle. Kitchen work triangle is a concept which is used to determine the efficiency of kitchen layouts, that is both aesthetical and functional. The primary tasks in a home kitchen are carried out between the cooktop, the sink, and the refrigerator. These three points and the imaginary lines drawn between them make up the work triangle. The idea is that when these three elements are close to one another, the kitchen will be easy and different to use, cutting down the wasted steps. And there are few other rules of kitchen triangle. No leg of the triangle should be less than the 4 feet or more than the 9 feet. The sum of all three sides of the triangle should be between the 13 feet and 26 feet. Cabinets or other obstacles should not intersect any leg of the triangle by more than 12 inches. If possible, there should be no more traffic flow through the triangle. And next one is some of the softwares which are used for interior designing. And we have learned about SketchUp Pro in CMTI. So here is a small introduction to SketchUp Pro. SketchUp Pro is a 3D modeling computer program for a wide range of drawing applications such as architectural, interior design, landscape architecture, civil and mechanical engineering, film and video game design. These are some of the advantages of SketchUp. It is simple to use and tools are very easy to remember. It is a lightweight 3D program. Free versions are available and 3D warehouse has very vast number of components, and it also gives satisfying results. These are some of the shortcut tools used in the SketchUp Pro. This is how the window of the SketchUp Pro looks like. The basic operation of SketchUp Pro is we can draw, model, paint, create, view, and export, and we can also render the plugin, and we can do background setting also. Here are some of my renders. So this is a hillside forest guest house with all the basic amenities, dining table, living room, a bedroom, and this is another another design of a bedroom. This is interiors of office. And these are the renders of road. Next, I would like to give a small introduction to Vastu. Since most of the people nowadays prefer Vastu construction, it is important for a civil engineer to know, to have a basic knowledge about Vastu to meet the requirements of the office of the customers. Significance of eight directions. We have four cardinal and four intercardinal directions. Each direction signifies an aspect of life and is governed by various codes. Vastu is nothing but the construction of house according to the nature. While north is the direction of wealth, south is for dharma, west and east are for prosperity and overall success. These are few of the basic principles of Vastu. Firstly, the shape of the shape. The rooms of our house should preferably be square or rectangle. And the room basics, the room should be airy, well-lit, bright and clean. This rule extends to the corners of each room. Next, the center of the home should be an empty space. And heavy furniture should be kept in the southwest direction. If planning to build a duplex house, building stairs in this direction is a good idea. We should avoid keeping plants and water features like water fountain, aquarium, painting depicting the water, etc. in the bedroom. And we should ensure that the dining space is near to the kitchen and not to the main door. Placing the mirror in the bedroom that reflects the sleeping couple is a strict no. If at all the mirror is placed in the bedroom, it should be ensured that the bed cannot be seen in it. Gateway or entrance of the house. Main door should be stronger and bigger than the other doors in the house. It should preferably made of the teak wood. An aquarium for the drawing room or living room. An aquarium on the northeast, north or east wall can be placed for the prosperity.
See, in most of the places, the teak wood is not affordable for the main door. So they take the frames only in teak wood and the shutters in any wood they take. In general apartments and all, the main door frame will be of a teak wood and the rest of the frames will be on sal wood or any other wood. And the shutters may be having a different variety. It may not be the teak wood. It is a pre-ready-made shutters they will use. Okay. Because ultimately the cost also matters. No?
Yes, sir. Next one is about the kitchen. We should keep the water sink away from the gas stove and fridge should be placed in the southwest direction and bedroom should be in the northwest direction. We should avoid overhanging beams in the room to enjoy the good health. We should use solid wooden beds instead of the hollow wrought iron beds. And when it comes to the study room, it should be square or rectangular shape for the study table. And hanging bookshelves are best avoided. And finally, the conclusion. Interior. Here we learnt about many concepts about interior. Interior design programs have been developed that help people in industry to improve their knowledge. Investing in the industry is quite essential as people currently adore the attractive looks in their buildings. And thank you. This was my report on interior design.
Good, good, Sristi.